Witness is Dr. George Fareed. Dr. Fareed is a family medicine specialist in Brawley, California, with over 50 years of experience in the medical field. He graduated with honors from Harvard Medical School in 1970. After two decades of teaching and researching in academia, he returned to clinical medicine to establish a general practice. Dr. Fareed is currently the medical director and family medicine specialist at Pioneers Medical Center in the Imperial Valley. In the past few months, Dr. Fareed has treated countless COVID-19 patients, both outpatient and inpatient. Dr. Fareed.
Thank you. Mr. Chairman, senators and colleagues, thank you for...
Is your mic on?
Oh, I hope so. Can you hear me?
Yeah, try and bring it a little bit closer.
Okay.
And by the way, all of your... I know you have longer testimony. I know you have different attachments to that. All that will be entered in the record. Mm-hmm. Dr. Fareed.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, senators, and colleagues. Thank you for convening this hearing. I have a background in virology, as you mentioned, an academic background, research standpoint from work at the NIAID as a professor performing research at Harvard Medical School. After I graduated from Harvard in 1970, I became a professor there, and later at UCLA School of Medicine. About 30, 31 years ago, I decided to go into clinical medicine, which was my real passion. I chose a rural area, underserved, where I thought I could make a difference. And I've had experience in that 30 years treating HIV, other infectious diseases, and practicing as a primary care medicine provider and being a hospitalist. My experiences during the pandemic treating COVID patients, both in the COVID flu stage as outpatients and also as hospitalized patients in the ICU, made me determined to prevent the COVID flu from progressing to the horrible, lonely cytokine storm suffering that I saw in the ICU, and I still see it. We accomplished this with what I present here today. Like everything else in medicine, the goal is to treat early. COVID patients are difficult to treat when they get very sick. The Imperial Valley, where we work, became the COVID epicenter for California in June and July. Since early March, both in my Brawley clinic and Dr. Brian Tyson's All Valley Urgent Care Clinic in El Centro, where I also work, over 25,000 fearful people were screened. Over 2,400 were COVID-19 positive, and we treated successfully over 1,000 high-risk and symptomatic ones. The interesting thing to me is that Dr. Tyson and I independently came to the same protocol for that purpose back in March. And we based it upon the great work from Dr. Zelenko and Dr. Raul, actually. They're our heroes, actually. It was a triple hydroxychloroquine cocktail, HCQ, 3,200 milligrams over 5 days, azithromycin or doxycycline, and especially zinc, which is often left out in the studies. The cocktail is best given early, as Dr. McCullough has indicated, within the first 5 to 7 days where the patient is in the flu stage. The timing of the drug is when the virus is in a very active maximal replication phase in the upper respiratory tract, and our goal has been and still is to prevent it from entering the lower respiratory tract and to prevent hospitalization. And we achieved this in over 1,000 patients, and that was involved reevaluating them at 2 to 3 day intervals. We blend in corticosteroids and prolong the HCQ treatment for 5 or more days if symptoms warrant, but they generally did not and do not. We use it especially in the high-risk individuals, as Dr. McCullough indicated, those over 50 to 60, those with comorbidities, or actually in anyone with moderate to severe flu symptoms. We want to avoid the COVID, long COVID syndrome in all patients that happens after they recover. The healthy do not need the treatment. I use this regimen to treat 31 elderly nursing home residents in an outbreak in June, and 29 recovered fully. The drug works mechanistically through multiple actions, the ionophores, HCQ, the gun, and zinc, the bullet. HCQ blocks the sigma-1 receptor and has several other direct antiviral effects. The antibiotic also has an antiviral effect and potentiates the action of HCQ and zinc. As additional anti-COVID agents become available, they can be added to this regimen to enhance its efficacy. And we are routinely now combining ivermectin, which you mentioned, Chairman, in a quadruple HCQ-IVM cocktail with excellent results, since ivermectin is safe and has a different anti-COVID action. This becomes Analogous to the use of multiple agents for HIV treatment, monoclonal antibodies from Regeneron and Lilly will be suitable also when readily available. The results are consistently good, often dramatic, with improvement within 48 hours. We wouldn't have stayed with this if it weren't helping people and always reliable. We've seen very few hospitalizations. We've seen not a single negative cardiac event. Our experiences are in line with all the studies that Dr. Risch has mentioned concerning early use of the HCQ cocktail. Let me be clear, this is only about the science of viral replication, the science of the stages of COVID, and the science why early treatment works. And early treatment has led us to actually try to communicate our approach. We think it should be on a national level. We wrote a letter with my colleagues to the president, a letter to congressmen, a letter to the California Health Department, an open letter to Dr. Fauci, and a national plan for COVID-19. As we describe in the national plan, this approach would be part of the solution to the pandemic. Protect the vulnerable, and if high-risk individuals get sick, there is a solution for them with early treatment with the antiviral cocktail. If early treatment becomes widely available, people will be much more confident going back to work and sending their kids back to school. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Fried. Our final witness is Dr.